I think this is one of the last things. So how you measure, now different channels have different measurement, right? I've just tried to put it all together in one, because whenever we're measuring content, and you as a person who handles digital or social or content, you will have multiple channels which you manage, right? You will, for example, like we were discussing, some content like Paridhi's content will first be in a form of an infographic, and then it will be in the form of maybe a video, right? Or an article. So when you have different forms and you have different channels where you put it up, you have to look at the metrics from a universal point of view, right? You can't say just because it's on YouTube, I'll only look at video views. So what we do is there are a few metrics which are common across, right? How many people have seen my content? Now, seen the content can be two things. One is, and I'll quickly just go to this. One is seen this, right? How many people have read 21 useful products that every workaholic needs to check out? So this is an impression of this article, right? How many people have clicked on this article and actually come to the page, like the page itself of the article? Now, this is called a page view, right? Which means this is one impression, right? And this is one page view. Now, there is a possibility that imagine all of us, what we are 12, right? In 12 of us, right, all 12 of us have seen this, which means there's one impression each. So there are 12 impressions on this article, Reddit article. Hello's article. So 12 impressions. However, only four of us clicked on this article. Okay. So impressions are four. Sorry, impressions are 12, clicks are four. Right? Now this is a page view. Right? So you click, so 12. So what happens is 12, four people clicked, right? I imagine I saw this article and I immediately bounced back because I don't want to read this. So I bounced back. So what happens is, though impressions are 12, clicks are four, your page view and the number of people who have actually read the article or stayed on the page for more than 10 seconds, because bounce back is in 10 seconds if you bounce, then it's not considered as a page view, right? So out of four of us, only two of us have actually, imagine, gone down and read, right? Then what happens is the page view is two. So how we track this here, right, is impressions is 12. This visitors is your page view, right? So this actually comes up. So your clicks are four. People who have read are two, right? Now, out of two, only one person has liked the article. So your comment, like, and share is one, right? So what happens here is you are actually making a funnel, right? Out of this, how many? Out of this, how many? Out of this, how many? Now, engagement rate is this divided by this, which is one person divided by 12 people who came is the engagement rate, right? That's how you calculate engagement rate. So one divided by 12, that's a percentage. Now, video views. Now, imagine if in the article, now obviously because we have taken only one person has come down. Imagine if this was a video, right? Imagine this is on YouTube and content can be anywhere, right? It can be on a blog, it can be on YouTube. Imagine on YouTube, you have 5,000 people who saw the thumbnail of the YouTube video, right? Out of 5,000, you have 2,000 people who have clicked on the thumbnail, right? Here, you will have video views instead of page views, right? Here, you will not have page views because it's a video. It will have video views. Now, out of 2,000 people who clicked on it, there are 500 people who actually watched more than 15 seconds. That's how a video view is captured, right? So, 50, more than 15 seconds or 50%, however, of the video. So, you have 500 people who saw the video, right? Now, what happens here is your average view duration, right, may be 60% of the video. That after people watching 60% of the video, people are dropping off, right? So people have, and you will calculate, saying out of 500 people, how much seconds did that person watch my video for? Basis this, you will come up to, and this report you get on YouTube and all of these channels, even Facebook video, you get a report of how much percentage people have averaged watched, right? So you have 60% people have watched. Now watching this video, there were 70 people who subscribed to my YouTube channel. So then I have 70 as a number here. And likes and dislikes is out of the 500 people who watched my video, right? I had 170 likes and 20 dislikes. right? Is this clear, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. I'll quickly just remove this. Edit this one. Okay, so just there's just one more metric before I give you all your assignments. There is something in articles, and this is not available across all publishers. That's why I've just put it as separate. There are some publishers who capture saying to read this article, it takes, for example, right, to read this article, imagine I calculate, and this they do through actual reading and figuring out, right? Think to read this article, I usually will take 3 minutes. So what I'll do is on this page, you have analytics, right? You can see how much percentage of how much time have people spent on this page, average, right? So I will say this page requires 3 minutes to read. Usually people have only stayed on this page for 1 minute, 12 seconds. So I will capture how much of interest or how much the person would have actually read, right? So that is called as average read depth. Saying how much time does it take to read the entire thing? Out of that, what is an average people read? And that becomes your depth. So 1.12 seconds, minutes divided by 3 minutes is going to be your percentage here. You can do this across all your articles. You can download this report from Google Analytics or your publisher website. And you will know which are the articles where people are reading the entire article because it's interesting, right? The last thing is enthusiasm. Enthusiasm is this. I would have read this article would have come to me on Facebook, right? I have come here. I have read this article. After I come, because I loved the article, what I will do is I will then come here and I will read on this. I will click on this. I will read this article. Then after I read this, I will again go down and I'll click on another article and I'll go and read that article, right? So now what happens is I have read 3 articles. So I've come in through 1 article, but I've read 3, right? So how many people do users visit after they come to your website? So here they come to the website is 1. After that, they have gone to 2 other articles, right? So that is 3. So this is how you actually see whether, you know, the content itself is engaging, right? So just final things in content marketing that we do is you obviously research about who are the people, and we discuss this, right? Who is the audience? What do they want to read about? Why are you as a brand putting up content? All of that happens in the first stage. The second is saying, what's the objective? Do I want people to buy more Decathlon products? Do I want people to upload more user videos? Do I want people to make more healthy snacks? All of that happens in goal setting. The content strategy we discussed, that you have to go through all the processes of finding out what's the frequency required, which are the platforms, what's the format you have to put the content. That's content strategy. Then you tell your content writer to actually write content basis that format. Right, then you have content curation. Now what happens is there is a curation is where you put together a lot of things, right? So there are a lot of articles which will you would have put in blogs, you would have put in your video, you would have put on YouTube. You curate all the content together, right? And then you decide saying this has more life in it. There are going to be more people who will read it. So I put up something on Instagram Live, right? I saw that it got a lot of engagement. So I curate that content and then I decide to publish it on Times of India. So I will do Times of India. I will pay them additional 50,000. I will say, this is my best performing content. Promote this, right? So all of that happens in the content curation stage. Distribution is where you go and you decide with your media planner person saying all these content are my best content. I want to promote for 50,000 here, 20,000 here, 70,000 here. Then I measure, right? That what is my audience doing with my content? Are they, you know, liking it? Are they sharing it? Are they reading more? All of that happens in your engagement stage. So our last thing, and this is an assignment for this.
Thank you.